Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let's take a look at 10 things to try out as soon as you update to macOS Big Sur. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 750 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There, you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So once you upgrade to macOS Big Sur, you may want to try out some of the new features. Here are 10 things that you should look at right away. A new feature in Big Sur is the Control Center, and you get to it by clicking here, and it brings up all sorts of controls that before would have been in individual little menu bar icons here. Now you can customize Control Center by going to System Preferences, and then Dock and Menu Bar. And on the left here you'll see Control Center. The first group of items are things that are always in the Control Center, but you can also determine whether or not they're in the Menu Bar as well. Then below that you've got other modules. These are things that could be in the Control Center, the Menu Bar, both, or neither. So you can add something to Control Center by checking Show in Control Center. Big Sur offers some exciting new choices for desktop backgrounds. Depending upon how Apple releases the final version of Big Sur and whether you're upgrading or getting a new Mac, you may or may not see this as your default background, this colorful background, rather than a picture of scenery. However, if you go to System Preferences and then to Desktop and Screensaver, you'll see all of your desktop options. So under Desktop Pictures here, you actually can choose a picture of Big Sur. You could also go back and choose Catalina. And these are dynamic desktops, so they will change according to the time of day. In addition to that, Apple includes a lot of other photos and things here, even going back to some older ones. Now, Apple also has a few really cool illustrations here under Dynamic Desktop, like this one, and it will change throughout the day as well, and others that include beautiful scenery. So check all of those out and pick one, but you know, feel free to change from day to day until you find one that best fits your style. Now the Notification Center and Widgets work differently in Big Sur. Instead of having two different modes, either Notifications or Widgets, they're both together. You have Notifications at the top and Widgets at the bottom. And you customize these a little differently. It's a little more similar now to iOS. So scroll to the bottom here, click Edit Widgets, and here you can go and choose other widgets in different sizes and just drag them over to the widgets on the right, or click the minus button to remove them. You can look at the different apps here that use them, and of course you may in the future have some third-party apps that add widgets as well. Now let's jump into the Messages app. The Messages app has a lot of new features in it. One of them is to pin conversations. So you know you have those people that you're always messaging with, and instead of having them actually be in this list with everybody else, you can put them at the top. Just click and drag any conversation to the top and you can add it here and pin it. And now these conversations will always be at the top and larger than your other ones. You can always drag back down below, unpin. And there are a few new message types that you can send. One is to use Memoji or Animoji. Click here and choose Memoji stickers. Now if you already have a Memoji set up, say you set it up on iOS, it's going to sync across using iCloud, and now you'll be able to use it to send a Memoji like this. You could also go and create your own right here on your Mac. You don't have to do it on your iPhone anymore. You can click here and choose New Memoji to create one on your Mac. It's also now easier to send animated GIFs. You don't have to go to a website and find one and copy and paste it over. You can click here and choose Images, and it works just like it does on iOS. So you can search for a GIF and choose something appropriate to send. One of my favorite new features in Big Sur is in the Photos app, and its ability to make adjustments, apply filters, and even crop and rotate videos as well as photos. So here I have a video in the Photos app. I can click Edit, and you can see I've got Adjust here, and I can adjust the lighting for the entire video. I can apply filters to the entire video, and I can even crop and rotate the video. There are a few new features in the Maps app as well. One of those is Look Around, which is similar to Google Street View. It's not available everywhere yet, but Apple's adding new cities all the time. So for instance, here I can click on a landmark, and then you can see I get Look Around here. I click there, and now I can look around on the street, and I could click on a spot and move forward and move around. And these are actually really beautiful and well done, pretty high res images. Another new feature is Look Inside. And this works for things like shopping malls, airports, other large indoor spaces. So for instance here I could see the shopping center and I could just keep zooming in on it and I could actually see the individual stores and things inside of a space. Of course, it's not available everywhere. Look for the little look inside indicator to let you know that it's available at this location. And another new feature is cycling directions. So now when you do directions in Maps, you can do by car, walking, public transportation, and cycling. Big Sur marks the first time in a long time that Apple has changed the system sounds. They've updated them. So you may want to go into System Preferences and then Sound and pick a new General Alert sound here. Each one keeps elements of the sound that it replaces, but they're a little different now. So you probably want to check them out and pick one that you don't mind hearing over and over again. And here's one last one to check out if you're using a MacBook. In System Preferences, under Battery, a new section here called Usage History. And you can actually see the use and charging history of your battery. So I can see the battery level here in a graph. I can see when I had it actually plugged in. And I can compare that down here to my screen usage. I can look at all these details for the last 24 hours. And I can look at a more generalized view for the last 10 days of how much battery power I've used each day. So check these things out after you've upgraded to Big Sur. Thanks for watching. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.